Hello, friends. This is David Morrison with Prosperity and Financial Advisors, along with Kristen McKenzie, and we want to give you a few quick thoughts about real financial planning. So the term financial planning gets thrown around frequently. Often, planning is used by some in the financial industry as just a sales tool. Tell us all about your situation and we'll find some product or service to sell you. But that is not real financial planning. But there actually is a definition of the elements of a real financial plan.
That's right, David. Oftentimes people think about a financial plan as just involving saving and investing strategies. And in fact, the CFP Board defines financial planning as the process of looking at a client's entire financial picture and advising them on how to achieve both their short and long-term financial goals. So in addition to investments, a comprehensive financial plan covers insurance needs, income and estate tax planning, retirement planning, and it may even involve specific goals such as education or business planning.
So if that is a financial plan, what's not a real financial plan? Well, it's not an online calculator. And it's not just an investment portfolio or an insurance policy or a variable annuity strategy. How do we see a real financial plan? It starts with what's important to you, your most important goals, and your deeply held values.
So after getting a feel for your goals and your values, the next step in our financial planning process involves doing a detailed, fact-based analysis of your current financial situation. There's no guessing or estimating involved. And then a common misconception is that the financial planning process is complete after we deliver a list of recommendations to a client. And in fact, the most overlooked piece of the planning process is implementing these recommendations, actually helping our clients put them to work. So a real financial plan is not a one-time event. It's an ongoing, continuous process because, as we know, life is constantly changing, and a plan that made sense a few years ago likely doesn't fit anymore.
So what would be the value to you of having a real financial plan like that? We believe that your future, your goals, your plans are much too important to depend only on guessing or hoping or assuming. They deserve careful consideration and fact-based strategies. A real financial plan can help you when the unexpected happens in your life. Now, that could be good surprises, like a sudden opportunity. Say you find the perfect mountain house, or you get invited to a wedding in Europe, or your kid gets into Harvard. Or it could be an unexpected challenge, a job loss, or a devastating fire, or a health crisis. A real financial plan helps you get through these types of surprises. Mm-hmm. And finally, you know, we hear from our clients that having a real financial plan can help provide financial confidence. And couldn't we all use a bit more confidence these days? So that's what a real financial plan is. If you have one, thank your advisors. If you don't yet, let's talk about how a real financial plan could be valuable to you. This is David Morrison with Kristen McKenzie. Thanks for watching.